Kenta packs a serious punch, but at what cost? When I box, I always get bruises on my shin, so I have to put ice on them to heal. Tata's mother, who's often ringside during his fights, has mixed feelings about her 9-year-old son boxing.
I do feel pity for my son when he gets hurt. I know he's hurt when he's in the ring. But he always tries to hide it and tells me about it later. I feel bad, but I know this is what he likes. So I have to fully support him.
Thai lawmakers have sought to ban boxing for children under the age of 12, but to no avail. Research has shown extensive damage could impact children's intelligence levels and brain development. Boxing causes brain injuries, as we can clearly see from older boxers. Boxers are at a risk of memory loss, losing the ability to control their muscles, and Parkinson's disease. In 2018, a 13-year-old boy died after a Thai boxing match, renewing pressure on Thailand to ban children from the sport. But its popularity and revenue potential has kept it thriving. Tata, despite the risk, wants to cash in. One day I can afford to buy my mom a house, car, and earn more money for her.
The main income of the family at the moment comes from Tata. For example, the last fight he had helped pay off all my debts.
Until the law in Thailand changes, children like Tata will be allowed to put themselves
relatively frequently in Europe.
Using older computers, scientists have mapped most of the planet. But regions around the north and south poles are still missing. And that 17% is crucial for workable weather simulations. And that's where the new computer comes in. It might need 2 weeks for this highly complex task, but that's still 4 times faster than its predecessor. So just how fast is this supercomputer?
You can do a direct comparison and say that the processors are similar to our own personal PCs. Similar because they're a little more evolved. In one system here, you have the equivalent of 15 or 20,000 PCs.
It was also right here in Stuttgart that one of the world's first high-performance computers, the Cray 2, was built. That was 1985, what was back then cutting-edge technology and roughly the same computing capacity as a modern smartphone.
Don't forget that in the 1980s, the Cray 2s were extremely fast machines. And since then, technical developments have enabled us to go smaller and smaller. So at the end of a 35-year evolution, our speed has been doubled every 18 months.
The supercomputers have also become more energy efficient, although they still need as much electricity as a small town with 40,000 residents. But their simulations can help make wind farms, for example, more effective. This footage is from the predecessor of the new computer. The aim here is to calculate wind turbulence and how it impacts on potential interference between individual turbines. And supercomputers are helping to improve those simulations. The scientists already have a preliminary 3D model of particulate matter pollution in Stuttgart, right down to each street. This data might later be used to create a prediction model for the level of pollution on your own doorstep. The scientists also want their models to be accessible to the man and woman on the street.
10 or 15 years ago, these systems were only seen in research and, to a degree, in industry. Today we have simulations that are far less technical and all the more relevant for the general public.
As seen in this depiction of an entire city in which residents glide from A to B. But some simulations are simply there to behold, such as this recreation of the birth of a galaxy. A picture that would not need 1,000 words, but 10,000 years on a regular home computer.
Wanted answered. We're happy to help out. Send it in, and if we answer it on the show, you'll get a little surprise as a thank you. Come on, just ask. You'll find us at our website, dw.com/science, or on Twitter.
Iverson Kingdom wants to know, why do volcanoes erupt? They look so peaceful, until they're not. Dozens of volcanoes erupt every year. Most lie at the scene where tectonic plates, land or beneath an ocean, push against each other or move apart, making the Earth's crust unstable. Volcanoes are the planet's way of letting off steam. The Earth is made up of layers. In the thick mantle along the core and beneath the thin outer crust, rock melts into magma at a great pressure and temperature. The magma expands and pushes upward. When it breaks through the surface, it's called lava. There are different kinds of volcanic eruption. If a massive column shoots into the sky, it's called a plenian eruption. When the magma heats up water, causing an explosion of steam, it's called phreatic. Some glacial ones occur when lava meets ice, usually under a glacier. These are just 3 examples. There are several more categories. Conical may be the iconic form, but in fact volcanoes come in many shapes and sizes. When lava breaks through a crack in the earth, a mountain can form quickly, or it can take tens of thousands of years.
busy open plan office. Would she feel more stress, and will her cortisol level be higher? Researchers in Dortmund have developed a program to model the noise in an open plan office before it's even been built. The arrangement of everything from desks to printers to room dividers makes a big difference. This is what it sounds like in a poorly configured open plan office. And now with room dividers.
Und zur Softwareinfo. Our software helps make people who are going to design an office more aware of the issues. We can only work with representative examples of office design. That's a limitation, because reality presents a far broader range of factors that we're unable to incorporate.
So after the test of the quiet individual office, Bianca now has to deal with the noise of this open plan office, which again gives us saliva samples. Is she feeling more stressed than on the previous day? Bianca's cortisol level did rise slightly during her 4 hours in the big office. The single office decreased over the same period of time, though the initial level that day was up. Our experiment is more of a snapshot than hard evidence. Researchers have yet to conduct long-term studies on how working in a big office affects stress levels. It is, however, clear that less noise is much better than lots of noise in an office environment.